こんにちは、アツです、今回もですね、アンジュと一緒に、動画を撮っています。今回はですね、アンジュに、面白いチャレンジをしてもらいました。それはですね、ネイティブスピーカーは IELTS で満点を取れるのかっていうチャレンジです。IELTS って試験知っている人どれくらいいるかわからないんですけれども、 IELTS っていうのは、TOEFL とかの試験に似ていて、海外の大学受験とかで、よく使われる試験になります。で、9点満点 0.5 点刻みの試験で、リーディング・リスニング・スピーキング・ライティングの4技能の試験です。で、私が受けたのは確か5年前ぐらいだったと思うんですけれども、その時はリーディング・リスニングで 9.0 満点、スピーキングで 8.0 で、ライティングで 7.5 で、オーバーオールが 8.5、 9点満点ですね、っていう風になっています。で、その時ですね、私はもっと高い点数取りたかったんですね。なのでちょっと悔しい思いをしました。でもですね、IELTS ものすごい難しい試験で、ネイティブでも満点取れるかどうかわからないっていう声がよくあるんです。なので、ここでちょっとですね、アンジュネイティブなので、アンジュにですね、 IELTS の試験を受けてきてもらいました。 So Andrew, so I just explained that you have just taken the IELTS examination.
Yep.
So today I just want you to share your experience about the IELTS examination. Like, what sort of impression you had and what you thought about the difficulty or problems that you came across in reading, listening, writing and speaking. How confident are you that you scored 9 out of 9 in the first place?
To start off with, I think I'm reasonably confident of getting a 9 out of 9. Just because the way the scoring structure works, I think, you know, it could potentially work in my favor in that, you know, we don't have to get nines in every single area. It just has to average out to a 9. So I think, you know, if I do reasonably well in each area, it should be okay.
Yeah. Because your score is rounded up, so if you get like 8.75 on average, then you will get 9.
Yeah, so especially if we break it out sort of by section, I think speaking, I'd be fairly confident in getting a 9 because it's quite conversational. They ask questions about quite complex topics, but it's almost like a normal everyday conversation for me. So that part I don't really view as being too challenging.
So it was a face-to-face interview, was it?
Yeah, correct. So it was a face-to-face interview. I think it was around about, you know, 4 or 5 questions. So one of the questions, for example, was, tell me about where you grew up. Another one was, you know, how do you feel about markets?
Markets?
Yeah, markets being
as in
like not stock markets. Sunday markets.
Not as complicated as that.
Yeah,
like so, general.
Yeah, markets. Shopping markets.
Shopping markets.
Yeah, buy food. That art, that sort of thing. And another one was tell me about a time when you wake up early. And for that one, I think I spoke a little bit quickly because the examiner told me to keep going. But apart from that, I think speaking went relatively okay. So I think,
so you are fairly confident.
Fairly confident of getting a 9 in that one.
Wow. That's impressive. What about the other sections?
The other sections, so if we move on to reading. Reading was a little bit trickier. In that, so I'm fairly confident I did okay on that one because I actually did it twice, because the first time only took me about...
You did it twice?
Yes, I did it twice.
How much time did you have?
So it's an hour long. I spent half an hour doing it. The questions are quite varied, but I sort of sped through it once in the first half an hour, and then just had half an hour left over, didn't really know what to do with it, so basically just did it again. I think reasonably confident, but it is a little bit tricky in the sense that some of the questions aren't really language-based, it's more of a logic test. So some of the questions, I don't know if I answered them correctly, especially the ones where it's... true, false, and not enough information.
That part is a bit tricky, isn't it?
Yeah, it's the not enough information really throws you because it's hard to tell sometimes whether there isn't enough information or whether it's just a flat out no. So that's a little bit trickier, but again, there's a little bit of margin of error, so reasonably confident that I've done okay on that one.
Yeah. Well, as a native speaker, you've read English for how many years?
Yeah, many, many years.
Many years.
Yeah, I don't want to go into too much detail because that would give away my age, but a fair few years.
How was listening?
Listening was fine, I think. Mm-hmm. Again, reasonably confident that that one went okay. Mm-hmm. It's quite a bit slower than people normally speak.
Okay. That's good to know.
So it was interesting. What I found interesting was there were a variety of different accents. Mm-hmm. So I think, again, there were kind of three or four passages that they read out, and none of them were in the same accent. So it's really, I guess, a global emphasis, and it recognizes that English is really a global language. So
were they all native speakers?
Yes, native speakers, but yeah, completely different accents. So I think one was Australian, there was a British one, there's an American one, and there's a bit in a Kiwi accent as well.
Oh, Kiwi accent as well.
Yeah, so yeah, it's a variety of different accents. Mm. So it's, I think it's important to, I guess, have an understanding or an awareness of different accents, because English, obviously, being a global language.
I think that's an interesting aspect of the IELTS examination, and I think that makes a difference from the other English exams, because, for example, TOEFL, which I took about 5 years ago, purely focuses on American English. So I don't remember hearing any other different types of English accent.
Right. I picked that up quite easily, but could potentially be tricky for non-native speakers.
Okay, and the last section is writing. So, you know, everyone says that writing section is the hardest part of the examination. When I took the IELTS examination for the very first time, I scored only 6.0 in writing. Although I got 8.5 in reading, 8 or 8.5 in listening, and also I got 8.5 in speaking. But writing just stuck out like a sore thumb, you know?
Yeah.
When I compared it to the other sections, obviously it's weird that I scored only 6.0, right? So apparently there is really a high standard set for the writing section, but I'm very curious like how you feel about writing.
Mm. I think as a general concept, writing is quite difficult. Everything else, you can kind of get away with not understanding the language fully, because it's really only testing your understanding of parts of the language. Mm. So it's not the entire sentence or the entire paragraph. It's really just bits and pieces.
Yeah.
When you're listening, you're just looking for the one keyword so that you answer that particular question. So you're not, you don't have to transcribe the entire thing.
Mm.
I think for me, first of all, I almost ran out of time. So I didn't really have time to check over my writing. I think it went reasonably well. So I was sort of checking my writing as I went through.
Mm.
And I actually went over the word limit slightly, but not too much.
Yeah, that's fine, I think.
But yeah, it definitely took a lot longer than I expected.
Yeah.
I expected it to maybe take me 40, 45 minutes to write up parts A and B. But basically ended up taking the full 60 minutes, because when I write this type of writing, I like to plan for a little bit first, because I think it's counterproductive to just jump straight into it. So yeah, it took me a little bit longer than expected, I think.
Do you normally consider yourself as a good writer?
I would say so, yeah. Mm. So during my Year 12 exam, so my exam to get into uni, I actually did quite well. So I got 49 out of 50.
Oh, wow.
So for context, 49, it's not really a numerical mark, so it's not a percentage. Mm. It's a ranking to put you in a spot within the state.
Yeah.
So I think 49 put me in the top 0.05 percentile.
Single.
Yeah.
Wow.
So it's really a bell curve kind of situation. So
right there.
Yeah. So it gets harder and harder the more you get towards 50.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I'd consider myself a fairly decent writer.
Right. So this time we'll see.
Yeah, we'll see what
well happens. You did.
Yeah, I didn't really have time to proofread, so I think that's my main concern, but hopefully should be okay.
No excuses?
Yeah, no excuses.
Thank you very much for sharing your experience. That was quite interesting. I'm really looking forward to checking your score together.
So am I.
Maybe we can shoot a video when your results come out.
I would love to.
Distinction 1 and 2 that we've made together are available on our website at atsuego.show. So Distinction, such a beautiful book, isn't it?
It's one of the best, even if I do say so myself.
And also we have Paraphrase Eikaiwa going on Instagram, so please do check that out as well.
If you're interested in learning more about Atsuego, visit atsuego.com for more information.
Andrew and I are going to post more videos to share more stories and also do more challenges. So if you are interested in more videos like this, please subscribe to our channel. All right, thank you very much for watching. I see you in the next video. Bye.